Hello and welcome to The Gaggle, where we challenge and, if necessary, destroy media narratives. I'm George Sambioli. With me today, of course, is co-founder of The Gaggle, Peter Lavelle, host also of RT's talk show, Cross Talk. Well, Peter, there was an interesting article over the weekend in the New York Times about the American Civil Liberties Union, the ACLU, the long distinguished history, but apparently it's riven by very serious conflicts. So while its budget has now tripled. Actually, it now has a budget of $300 million, which is an extraordinary sum. It's tripled during the Trump years. It doesn't seem any longer to be interested in the sorts of issues that the ACLU traditionally has been interested in, most particularly the First Amendment, free speech, freedom of assembly, freedom of religious worship, then the various other elements of the Bill of Rights, like due process, rights of counsel, unreasonable search and seizure. All of those items in the Bill of Rights has always been the ACLU's bailiwick. And of course, and we've talked about this before, we remember the famous 1976 case that they brought, defending the rights of Nazis to march in Skokie, Illinois. You know, ACLU, you know, led most often by Jewish lawyers. Nonetheless, they brought this case, succeeded in permitting the ACLU, the neo-Nazis to march in Skokie. But now, the ACLU doesn't seem to be terribly interested in free speech, with speech be in danger on various platforms, the internet platforms. They're being people again getting kicked off for their views for no other reason. We have serious free speech issues in universities. Most seriously, we have the cases where where there are rape allegations in universities, and where under Obama, the accused men, usually men, accused men had very few rights. And the Trump administration kind of changed that to give more due process to accused young men. The ACLU is taking the opposite position, which is they're favoring essentially railroading accused young men. So we're kind of seeing that the ACLU is taking political positions very much on the left, on kind of, you know, the liberal left, and are abandoning its basically traditional concerns. Now, some of it has to do with the money. I mean, the fact that their budget has trebled during these years means that the people who are putting it money want to use the ACLU essentially to bash Trumpism, you know, the right and so on. And they're not terribly interested in the ACLU's traditional interests. And if you look at just the salary of this guy who's the head of the ACLU, he's making $500,000 a year. This is a nonprofit. Why is somebody who's head of the ACLU making $500,000 a year? So you have to think there's ideology involved here. There's also money, and it's a very troubling situation.
Some of their associates are making $250,000.
Yeah. That's a very big money for a nonprofit.
Well, I don't know when we remember Skokie, Illinois. I mean, that was like a noble cause. I mean, terribly painful because it really made you come on one side or the another on freedom of speech and assembly. And that was unpopular speech is the speech that needs to be protected.
Right. Right.
Okay. And the disgusting message of the Nazi marchers. I mean, it was just repugnant. Okay. In a predominantly Jewish community. But the American Civil Liberties Union said, "Damn it, we're going to do the right thing." Okay, and they did it, and that's the case we all remember, George. Yeah, that's the case we remember. So what are they doing now? They're favoring their clients over principles.
Good. Yeah. No. That's exactly right. And what they're doing here is pursuing an anti-Trump agenda. which is not really what it's supposed to be about. So the cases, that it's supposed to be bringing, it really isn't bringing them, because it seems like many people, the ACLU, say, well, why should we defend the free speech rights of people whose views we find reprehensible?
Yeah, but that was the whole point of the organization.
Exactly, and they're buying into the idea, well, you know, if you're somebody's free speech is causing offense to somebody else, it's victimizing someone. So we're not going to defend your free speech rights because when you speak, you're victimizing someone. That is a, dangerous path to go down on.
They're choosing politics over principles, unfortunately. Okay, they're favoring some clients over others. They're favoring certain issues over others, and instead of just sticking to the Bill of Rights, which basically was their primary foundational reason to come into being, right, it's almost completely abandoned it, and it's really, and then it just essentially they're saying is that they will favor speech of some over others, which again is a complete violation of their foundation. I mean, if you're going to defend the most noxious of the noxious out of principle, why can't you support people that don't watch MSNBC or CNN, okay? And that's essentially what they're saying. So it's a complete abandonment of it. I mean, I find it really, really sad because those guys were heroes. Seriously. Right. I mean, it took guts to do with some of the things that they did. Yeah. And they did it with such passion and conviction. And now it just looks like the sloppy picking winners for money.
And so when you look at, let's say, you know, the case of the people who were involved in January the 6th, where are the ACLU on this? I mean, here they are. People are being held, you know, without bail, in solitary confinement, yet the charges against them are what? Trespassing, loitering. It's obviously they're being persecuted for their political views, yet the ACLU is nowhere. Where was the ACLU when the Mala was going in and breaking into Roger Stone's apartment at dawn? Why? For somebody who's alleged to have lied to the Congress? That's you come in guns drawn for that?
What about General Flynn when the Justice Department dropped their case against him and Judge Sullivan says, I'm not done yet? I mean,
exactly.
I mean, they should have just come in and said, this is a bastardization of the law. This judge should be disbarred, absolutely, impeached.
Exactly. That's exactly right. That's where you're supposed to come in. You're supposed to defending people's due process rights. If the government decides that they want to, the new evidence has come emerged and they want to drop a case, then that's the government's responsibility. They're the ones who bring the charges. They're the ones who drop the charges. Where does a judge get off, decide that he's not going to allow it? Judge is just supposed to be a neutral arbiter. He's not supposed to be doing the prosecution himself. That's not the American system.
Yeah, but see, what they're doing now is they're looking at progressive issues and evaluating their relative importance to them for ideological reasons. Before, they would just say, what's the case? I don't care what the speech is, okay? Right. It's being violated. It doesn't, content of the speech doesn't matter. What matters is it is being violated, and we need to search and protect that person and find a remedy. I mean, none of the lawyers who were primarily Jewish that defended the Nazis in March and Skokie, I mean, do you think that they gave one shred of credence to what these people were saying? Of course not. They were just saying they have a right to say it, okay? But now they're just saying, no, we're gonna pursue cases that involve transgenderism with reparations. This is all a progressive agenda.
That's right. Yeah, no, that's exactly right. And so again, Amazon refused to sell a book by an author who was questioning the transgenderism, or basically the hysteria that is leading to so many women to choose to undergo transgender surgery and therapy and so on. She wrote a book about this. And Amazon said, oh, we're not gonna handle it again. And the ACLU, that's right, you know, two thumbs up for that.
What happened? You know, I mean, this is one, this is a foundational experience of our lifetime, right. Okay? We only know of them because they stood up and protected the rights of people that you and I would never even shake hands with, okay? Right. But they still have a right to say what they want to say. As again, the lesson to be learned here, it is unpopular speech that needs protection. And if we walk away from that, then we walk away from the entire idea of free speech. It's just a dead letter.
Okay? No, that's
and speech is a privilege, and you have to earn it.
Exactly, because through human history, popes, priests, kings, dictators, presidents have always found very good reason to silence people. There's always a good reason. You know, we don't want bad influence. It might lead to violence. It might lead to social unrest. You know, people who have all sorts of wrong ideas in their head. There's always a good reason to censor. The whole point of the First Amendment is say there are no good reasons. People should have a right to speak. And there should be no restraint on that.
What we're experiencing right now is the deterioration of the free speech. And you know what that engenders? It engenders a winner takes all mentality, okay? And that was not what the Republic was based on, okay? I mean, you have to remember when the founders of it were painfully, you know, they Catholics left Europe. They actually settled in Maryland. That was a Catholic colony. And when they were drawing up the document, you know, there were Jews, there were Catholics, it was primarily Protestant, and they realized if this is gonna work, you're all gonna have to be able to say what you want to say, even though we're denominationally very different, and it even could be hostile, okay? But there's one thing that mediates. It's the principle, the First Amendment, freedom of speech. That's how we all kind of get along, okay? That was the whole point.
That's it, and that's the point. It doesn't matter that, you know, some people will find it offensive. Yeah, that's it, that's the way it goes. You know, if you say something, you know, somebody will be offended. Basically, the ACLU's position was to be, there is no right not to be offended. You know, that's not in the Bill of Rights. I have a right not to be offended. No, there's no such right. But there is a right to speak your mind. And I think that the fact that they've now gone down this a politically ideological path, which is, you know, supporting a one political faction and not, you know, what their basic core principles, shows that it's really,
well, and just
to spiral.
Just to top it off, and go look. See, we have the internet today. When the founding documents were written, you had pamphlets, okay? And some of the things they said in those pamphlets were outrageous. Right. I mean, mean-spirited, a pack of lies, misinformation, disinformation, right. Fake news, okay? But they said, look, that's the way it goes, okay? Particularly you're in public life. I mean, what do you expect here? Why? Because even Thomas Jefferson and John Adams, they hated each other. I mean, they fought each other for decades, but they always said, you have a right to say what you want to say, okay?
Yeah. That's
not today, not today.
We don't want to do as they did in England, where you put people in prison. You know, that's it. You know, you don't like someone, you don't like his religion, don't like what he says, you shove him in prison. I mean, that's it. That's the whole point. They didn't want to replicate the way it was in England. So, all right, Peter.
We're on local, so go to thegaggle.locals.com. And any help you can provide us would be much appreciated.
Exactly, very much appreciated. Helps us a great deal. And we're also on Rumble. Please look us up on Rumble. And if you like The Gaggle, please like, share, and subscribe. See you soon. Bye.